Hello guys, in this video I will show you how to make a paraglider like the one in Breath of the Wild. So first of all, we are going to create the paraglider actor. So right click on the content browser, click on blueprint class, click on actor, name this paraglider. Open it up. Go to add component, add a cone, rotate this in the negative y direction, so negative 90 degree, bring it to the front, then resize it a bit so it looks like a glider. Now go into your third person character. I am just going to delete my old node and variables. Now go to viewport, add component, arrow, position it like this. This is where the paraglider is going to spawn. Now we only have to spawn the paraglider when the character is at a minimum height above the ground. So in order to check this, we are going to use a land trace. So we are going to create a variable to store the minimum height. So add variable, type in min height, and the variable type should be float. Now right click on the graph and type E key. So we get the E keyboard event. Then from pressed, drag and type in land trace by channel. We are going to get the start and end location from the capsule component. So drag from here and type in get world location. Now for the end location, drag from the return value and type in break vector. We are basically going to subtract this minimum height from the C value. So the minimum height should be 300. And drag from here and type minus float minus float. Drag and drop this into this and right click on the graph, type in make vector, connect x to x, y to y, and this to C, and connect this to the end. So if the line trace hit something, this will return a value of true, and if the land trace doesn't hit anything, it will return a value of false. So we are only going to spawn the paraglider if this returns false. So drag from here and type in node boolean, press and hold B and click, so we get this branch, connect this to this and connect this to this, and if this is true, we are going to spawn the paraglider. Spawn actor from, so type in spawn actor from class, and the class should be paraglider. this transform can be obtained from arrow. So drag and drop that in and drag from here and type in get world transform. And connect this to spawn transform. Now we are just going to store this into a variable. So drag and promote to variable and name this glider reference. Now we are going to attach the glider to the arrow. So drag the arrow into the graph and right click on the graph and type in attach to component and connect this to here and this to target and arrow to the parent, and the location rule, rotation rule and scale rule all should be keep world. Now let's play. So now you can see that the paraglider was spawned when I pressed the E key. So we need to destroy it when we land, and also have to activate and deactivate it when I press the E key. Then we need to add the gliding effect. So go into your third person character. Create a new variable called is gliding. And change the variable type to boolean and compile. Press B and click. So we get this. Connect this to this. And the false should be connected to this. And drag and drop this into here. So if we are not gliding, we can spawn the paraglider. And if we are gliding, we will destroy the paraglider. So from this we will set isGlide. So we need to press Alt and drag and drop this in, connect this here, and this should be unchecked. Here press Alt and drag and drop this, and this should be checked. So if this is gliding, we will make this not gliding, and also we will destroy the paraglider. So for that, press Alt and drag and drop this in, then do an is valid check on it. We need the one with the question mark. And connect this to this and drag and type in destroy actor, and this will only destroy if the glider reference is valid. It won't attempt to destroy the glider if there is no glider in the first place. So this will prevent errors from happening. So we need to do this when we land also. So right click on the graph and type in on landed. We are just going to copy select all this and press Ctrl W to duplicate this and connect this to here. Now we need to make the gliding effect. For that, we basically need to change two values in the character movement component. The first one is gravity scale, this one, and the next one is air control, this one. So drag and drop your character movement component and drag from here and type in set gravity scale, and the scale should be 0.1. again, drag from the character movement component and type in air control, set air control, and change the value to 0.7. And when we land, we need to set the values back. So select all this, Control and W to duplicate this and connect this to here, and set this to 1, and set this to 0.05. we also have to do this here. So select these three and press Ctrl W to duplicate it and bring it here and connect it to this. So now we can glide. So there are two issues. One issue is that if we press E while jumping up, we will keep on moving upwards. And the other one is if we activate and then deactivate the paraglider in midair and activate it again, we won't glide but we will fall continuously down. Now this has to do with the C velocity of the character. Now I will show you how to fix this. So first of all, we need to disconnect this from here and make a new custom event. So type in custom event and type in glide. We also need to create a function to check the C velocity. So add function, the name should be is C velocity negative, and this should be a pure function, so we don't really have to connect this to event or anything. We can just call it like any other functions. So add an output, click on the graph and type in self, drag and get velocity. We need to break this and just get the C velocity. We need to check whether it is less than or equal to 0. So connect it to this. So add two branches, by pressing and holding B and clicking two times, and connect this to this and this to this and this to this, and drag and drop the is gliding here, and drag and drop the is e velocity negative here, and connect it to this. Now we are going to add a small C velocity using launch character. So drag from here and type in launch character. Then we are just going to give a small velocity of 5 in the C direction and check the C override. Then we are going to use a timer to call this glide event. So drag from here and type in set timer by function name. Set timer by function name, and the function name should be this name, glide. And I am just going to give it a value of 0.1. Now let's see if it is working or not. So as you can see, we can glide, but if we deactivate the paraglider while we are close to ground, we can't activate it again. But in Breath of the Wild we can do that. So in order to fix this, we just have to do one thing. So when we deactivate the paraglider using the E key, we just need to set the minimum height to 0, and when we land we are going to set the minimum height back to 300. So that's all you have to do to make a paraglider. So thanks for watching guys, and subscribe for more tutorials like this. Thanks.